Good morning all of you for joining this webinar. At the outset, I thank the organizers, especially the principal, the head of the department, coordinators and the convener, Dr. P. Sandaraman, G. Vengadaswamy Naidu College, GVN College, Koyilpatti. In the two sessions, I am very happy to share with you my research knowledge, my research experience, my journey, research journey with you. In the first session, I will give you a brief introduction to biosensors, especially how glucose biosensors, glucometer are fabricated or developed. Similarly, you can make your own biosensor in your laboratory for various applications, for various disease biomarkers. This lecture is made very simple, especially for beginners understanding, even by UG, PG and research scholars. At the end of the two sessions, I am sure you will be able to design and develop, fabricate your own biosensors for various your own applications. Now we will continue to watch the session. Thank you for joining. In the first session, I will give you a brief introduction to biosensors, what are biomarkers and their applications. In the second session, I will tell you our own research on design and fabrication of biosensors. Also, at the end, I have given a separate video on our own biosensor devices developed, fabricated in our lab, carried out in DPT, DRDO funded research projects. It could be used for any biosensors for any disease biomarkers. Before we learn about biosensors, we need to know about what are sensors, what are transducers, what is called a sensor. A sensor is a device which detects the changes in temperature, pressure, or changes in the analyte concentrations, biochemical concentrations, called biosensors, changes in temperature, or temperature sensor, changes in pressure measured by pressure sensor, etc., gas sensor. What is a transducer? A transducer is a device that converts one form of energy into another. For example, chemical signal. For example, when a protein is detected by chemical method, it is converted into electrical signal. In this slide, I have defined what is biosensor. What is biosensor? A biosensor is an analytical device which converts a biochemical response into an electrical or optical signal. I have shown here two biosensors, for example, commonly used, glucometer, pregnancy test. Glucometer are often used to measure the level of glucose in sweat or blood. Okay, whereas pregnancy test, it detects the HCG protein in urine. In this slide, I have given you the principle of biosensor. How it works, the biosensor, working mechanism of biosensor. Okay, here you have bioanalytes that interacts with the biorecognition element, bioreceptor. It is converted into electrical energy. For example, the chemical signal is converted into electrical signal by using transducer. It is amplified and the signal is processed and monitored on monitor. In this slide, I have given you the types of biosensors. What are the classification of biosensors? Biosensors are classified based on biorecognition element, bioreceptor or biocomponent, and the transducers. Okay, based on biocomponents, they are classified into antibody-based biosensor called immunosensors, enzymatic biosensor, microbial biosensor using cell as a recognition element. We can immobilize the cell on the electrode itself, or DNA biosensor, genome biosensor, phage sensor. And on the basis of transducers, they are classified into two main types: electrochemical biosensors and optical biosensors. You have optical fiber optic, surface plasma resonance, mass based, change in mass can be detected by using biosensor called piezoelectric biosensor. In the electrochemical biosensor, there are several types: ambrometric biosensor, which measures the change in the current and change in the potential and change in the conductance. As shown here, the cells have got a lot of receptors on its surfaces to sense the foreign bodies, changes in the environment. For example, coronavirus is rich in glycoprotein that binds tightly with the angiotensin converting enzyme 2 receptor on our human body cell. It leads to infection of coronavirus. Here I have shown the various components of biosensors and the principle involved in it. In that, molecular recognition is an important in the biosensor development. Biosensor development is a multidisciplinary field. For example, it involves chemistry, biology, biochemistry, electronics, physics, instrumentation, and we need to know marketing. Once you develop biosensor, you need to market the product, biosensor product. For example, we have developed biosensors. We need to know the marketing strategies to sell in the market our own product. Here I have shown the various applications of biosensor, especially in drug discovery, disease detection, environmental monitoring, soil quality in agriculture, toxins of defense interest, and food quality monitoring, water management, water quality management, etc. Among the various biosensors, optical biosensor, piezoelectric biosensors, electrochemical biosensors are very, very important because they are portable. They can be used for point of care applications, operation simplicity, low cost of fabrication, suitability for real-time detection, fast response, more sensitive. Here I have given the glucose biosensor, the mechanism of glucose biosensor, how glucose biosensor is fabricated. For example, glucose on reaction with the oxygen in the presence of enzyme called glucose oxidase to give gluconic acid and hydrogen peroxide. The glucose level can be monitored indirectly by measuring the decrease in the oxygen level using Clark electrode, or by measuring the increase in pH due to the formation of gluconic acid or hydrogen peroxide based biosensors. Here, the working electrode is here. It is coated or immobilized with the glucose oxidase enzyme. In the presence of glucose oxygen, it gives hydrogen peroxide. As a result, current is generated due to redox reactions, electrochemical redox reactions. Similar to glucose biosensor using glucose oxidase enzyme, cholesterol biosensor was developed and reported using cholesterol oxidase enzyme. This enzyme, cholesterol oxidase, oxidizes cholesterol to cholestinone to give hydrogen peroxide. This hydrogen peroxide on redox reaction gives current to increase. As you see in the cyclic voltammogram, a plot of current versus potential, there is an increase in the current signal in the presence of cholesterol. With the increase in the concentration of cholesterol, more hydrogen peroxide will be generated. The peak current also increases. Using hydrogen peroxide biosensor, we can measure the alcohol level, for example, ethanol in spirit, using alcohol oxidase as an enzyme. For example, ethanol reacts with the oxygen in the presence of alcohol oxidase enzyme to give acetaldehyde and hydrogen peroxide. Glucose, for example, we have discussed just before, glucose oxidase. For each bioanalyte, there are oxidase enzymes. For example, oxalate oxidase, glutamate oxidase. So you can detect the level of glutamate. Glutamate is an important neurotransmitter using oxidase enzyme. By measuring hydrogen peroxide, we can detect the level of sucrose, starch, glutamate, even oxalate oxidase, oxalate levels, etc. Here I have shown how the biosensor was developed for cancer cell detection. For example, cancer cell on its surfaces, melanocortin 1 receptor protein is overexpressed. On cancer cell surface, the protein melanocortin 1 receptor is overexpressed. Therefore, the antibody of this receptor protein is used for immunosensing cancer cell. Here, they have used a screen printed electrode. It consists of three electrode assembly connected to electrochemical workstation. It consists of working electrode, screen printed carbon working electrode, and a reference electrode and a counter electrode. The working electrode is modified with the antibody, modified or bioconjugated with the antibody of this protein. This protein is overexpressed on the surface of the melanoma cancer cell, skin cancer cell. The antibody specifically binds the cancer cell. Thereby, the cancer is detected and measured. This work was actually carried out by my own student, former research scholar, who is now in USA, carried out this work in University of Madison, USA. In this slide, the principle of genosensor, DNA biosensor, is described. For example, this is the working electrode on which the single strand DNA of the pathogenic organism is immobilized as a biorecognition element. When the blood sample containing the pathogenic bacteria, it will undergo hybridization. And there will be change in current, there will be change in signal impedance, or there will be change in current. The change in current is measured due to the nucleic acid hybridization. Thereby, the presence of disease-causing bacteria or present in the blood can be detected by using genosensor. This is the working principle of DNA microarray biosensor. This is based on the Genome sensor just now discussed. Each array, each cell consists of one electrode, electrode or optical based sensor here. Here the biorecognition element or the single strand DNA are used as probes. So each cell will be immobilized with the different pathogenic bacteria. By using this microarray kit, we can determine the various pathogens present in the water sample or blood, etc. It is also used for gene expression profiling. What are the genes expressed under the various disease conditions? For example, in cancer, what are the genes, what are the proteins overexpressed, what are the genes overexpressed. Genetic disease screening, we can identify the genetic disease. For example, diabetes mellitus, ALS disease, we'll be discussing later. Infectious disease monitoring and cancer treatment and also drug development, we can use for various applications. Here, the biomarkers of various diseases are listed out. What are biomarkers? Biomarkers are either small molecules such as glucose or proteins or DNA used to measure the progress of the disease, used as a marker of the disease. For example, diabetes mellitus, the biomarker for this is glucose, we have already seen. And heart failure, it is the biomarker is amino-terminal propeptide counterpart. And cardiac ischemia, the biomarkers are troponins, myoglobins. For cancer, PSA, EGFR are well-known biomarkers. If you know the biomarkers, or once biomarkers are identified in the progress of the disease, we can develop the biosensors or immunosensors to detect the various biomarkers and measure the progress of the disease and also measure the therapeutics of the drug. We have carried out joint research project with the DRDO. In one of our projects, we have developed biosensors for hypoxia. What is hypoxia? At high altitude, for example, in Mount Everest, the height is 8848 meters, whereas in Siachen, the height is 5400 meters above the sea level. At high altitude, for example, our Indian soldiers are in Siachen, where they protect us from foreign invasion. It is very, very difficult to survive at very freezing temperature, and also the oxygen level is very, very less at high altitude. Please remember, the oxygen level is very, very less. Therefore, it results in a condition called hypoxia. As a result of this hypoxia, many soldiers were susceptible to hypoxia disorders, and they die immediately within a week. Therefore, our military soldiers are first tested whether they are susceptible to hypoxia disorders. If you are susceptible to hypoxia disorders, then you should not go to Siachen or Mount Everest. Otherwise, you will have a chance of hypoxia disorder resulting in death. For example, what are the various hypoxia disorders, high altitude illness, suffered by our Indian soldiers? Hypobaric hypoxia, acute mountain sickness, high altitude cerebral edema, high altitude pulmonary edema. These are all various high altitude illness. suffered by our military jawans at high altitude due to hypoxia because of low oxygen concentration in at high altitude. Here, what are the organs affected? How they are affected? For example, respiratory organs are highly affected. There are cases of death of our military soldiers due to congestive heart failure, heart attack, multiple organ failure, etc. What are the various hypoxia biomarkers identified? For example, reactive oxygen species such as superoxide anion radical, hydrogen peroxide are important parameters of oxidative stress. Due to low availability of oxygen, they are produced in high concentrations. Nitric oxide metabolites such as NO2 minus, NO3 minus, these levels are reduced at high altitude. The patients suffering from hypoxia disorder, they will have these nitric oxide metabolites levels are low. Cytochrome C, for example, cell death, cysteine and oxidative stress, antioxidants enzyme. These are all various hypoxia biomarkers and also other biomarkers identified in literature and reported. What are the conventional methods? Now, we know the biomarkers for hypoxia. What are the methods available to detect, measure the level of biomarkers? For example, let us see chemical methods. Grease colorimetric assay, fluorometry, chemiluminescence, gas chromatography, mass spectrometry, HPLC. These are all. What are the biochemical methods available to detect the various biomarkers to identify the diseases? ELISA kit, Western plot, flow cytometry. What are the drawbacks of these methods? What are the drawbacks of these methods? They are very tedious and they are all not portable. They are not portable and time consuming, etc. For biosensor fabrication, biofunctionalization or bioconjugation is an important process in biosynthesis fabrication. What is biofunctionalization? For example, you have an electrode, working electrode, where glucose oxidase is immobilized or antibody is immobilized or single strand DNA is immobilized. It will not stick to the surface. It will not, these proteins or single strand DNA or antibodies, they do not stick to the electrode surface because they are washed away. Therefore, we need to immobilize by using bioconjugation method. The success of biosensor fabrication depends on the biofunctionalization, immobilization or bioconjugation. Here I have shown the mechanism of biofunctionalization, how they are biofunctionalized. For example, we have used here carbon nanotube, single walled carbon nanotube, and it is oxidized in the presence of air or in the presence of an acid, nitric acid to carboxylic acid, and then it is allowed to react with the thionyl chloride SOCl2 or amine to give the COCl, and then it is conjugated with the protein. This is nothing but your protein, or this is nothing but your protein. Now the electrode is the electrode surface with the CNT or CNT modified working electrode is now coupled with the protein. Now the proteins are tightly bound to the electrode surface. Therefore, the biosensor is stable and can be used for many times. There are several chemical methods are available for conjugation of enzymes or covalent binding of enzymes on nanomaterials modified electrode surfaces. For example, tresyl chloride method. There are several chemical methods. Glutaraldehyde, we have used to glutaraldehyde method. Here I have shown how the working electrode, the biosensor electrode, is modified and coupled with the enzyme, using carbodiimide. And here, using glutaraldehyde, how the enzymes are bound to the electrode surface, tightly.